Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to Darkest Dungeon Season 3. We are about to go fight the Drowned Crew today, marking the final boss in the cove for Season 3. On our team today, it's going to be Kate in the first position. I gave her Wilbur's Flag just so she'd have a little bit of stun resist. Also, of course, dodge. Maybe that'd help us out against the boss fight. Also giving her the Tempting Goblet, which is quickly becoming one of the best trinkets in the entire game that I've ever seen. Lars is going to be going for a standard bleedy slash off heals slash debuffer. Or not debuffer, but buff remover. I should say cleanser, I guess, is the best way to describe him, how I play him here. Malph is going to be here for our stress healing. And no real big surprise there. Last but not least, Austin. Still going for Healy Geely. You all know the story by nowzy. And again, thank you, everybody. A lot of people for showing concern about being sick. I'm still feeling a little congested, but I'm certainly a lot better than I was a couple of days ago. Especially since the last time I recorded. We'll go down to 6 because we do have the... Oh, no, wait. We don't have any plus food, do we? No. No. Okay. Just making sure. Yeah, we'll go for that many just in case we do get a random hunger event. Yeah. Here we go. The Drowned Crew. Take away Uncle Wayne.
While the greedy dogs slept off their revelry, I hexed their anchor with every twisted incantation I could muster, imbuing it with the weight of my ambition and my contempt for their crude extortion. At the witching hour, the anchor pulled with preternatural force, dragging craft and crew down into the depths. They must have cried out, but no sound escaped the swirling black waters.
All right.
The poor devils, chained and drowning for
eternity. Apparently,
Malph
is wasting. I didn't even realize that. I'm glad that I remembered to put some blood, some of the blood, I should say, onto the bars here. So there's going to be a no fuss, no muss type deal here with today's run. I know that the runs have been a little bit shorter than usual lately, but like I said, I'm sort of taking it easy. I want to make sure that I'm not lapsing on content too much. If this run is like super fast, then we might do another one
another
here.
Another mariner, another misfortune.
Yeah, we can afford to have two shovel vents in one hallway. Sure, why not? Why not?
A fortune, waiting to be spent.
And somebody left a comment saying that Invicta, we think when you're sick, you should probably try to play a less stressful game. I mean, honestly, like Darkest Dungeon doesn't really stress me out. It hasn't. This isn't the right way to go. Well, I'll be a son of a bee. Well, in that case, considering that like we have only two shovels left, we should probably not use any more. Wow, a lot of food. By food, I mean gold. This from this food. Yeah, I'd love to open that chest, except now that I know that I'm not going in the right direction, that sort of changes things. I would have bet the house on the fact that the boss would have been over here to the southwest rather, but, okay. Anyway, somebody left a comment saying, Zimikdu, we think you should not play a stressful game whenever you're sick. I mean, honestly, it just comes down to me. I know how to deal with the silliness that is the Darkest Dungeon-y RNG. Also known as Darkest Dungeon G. Maybe, I don't know. But yeah, I'm hopefully turned a corner here as far as the gunk is concerned. I just call it the sickness. Sinus infections are no fun, man.
For a task well performed.
Got the surprise pretty good. You might be worried about our backline DPS here, and you wouldn't necessarily be wrong in worrying about that. But as long as we have Kate and Austin, we can hit the backline without too much problem. So Kate should get the dunk right here, I hope. There we go. Elijah Cron is probably going to get guarded by one of the two champions, and that's fine. We've got bleeds for a reason. What's nice about having a flagellant is that we can get a bleed anywhere we want to, pretty much. If we need to hit the third position, we can go for If It Bleeds, or we can go for a Slice Off. If we need to hit the first two, of course, we just go for a Punish.
Give them no quarter.
It's a nice amount of freedom that we have whenever we're talking about distributing the amount of damage over time that we can dish out on this group. Of course, you know, predicated on us actually, like, you know, landing a bleed, because God forbid we actually land a bleed whenever, you know, we have a base of 140 versus a resist of 72 and 105. So you might be wondering, are you gonna put Exsanguinate? That's a great question. Stay tuned and I'll let you know. So eventually, one day we'll be able to land a bleed. Until then, we're just gonna be slamming our head against this brick wall known as the double Pelagic Champion. Hey, look at that, we finally landed a bleed, amazing.
Inspiration.
Thank you.
And improvement.
Thank you, Uncle Wayne. Alright. I'm not gonna go, well, I should go for a redeem. Alright, fine. I really wanted just to throw out bleeds there, but I guess Lars can live. I mean, now, I do want to say that going in here with just bleeding damage is not exactly ideal. I kind of don't want just bleeding damage. Like, if you can get blight damage, that's great. I'm going to go for the stun here. If you can just get blight damage, that's good. But, you know, if you have to go bleeding damage, it works out if you're able to land the bleeds, obviously. we have to hit one eventually. One day. I mean, yeah, he's got a base of 105 resist, but, you know, I'm remaining hopeful. Just remember, Darkest Dungeon does not get to have what it wants. You are the pack leader here. One day. Alright, we got there. Can we get two in a row? Oh my goodness, are you feeling okay, Darkest Dungeon?
Impressive.
You alright? You forget how to do Darkest Dungeon math all of a sudden? It's not the bleed resist that are bothering me, it's the fact that we're not landing our debuff that lowers the bleed resist. That's the one that's bothering me. So this Pelagic Champion will finally die here on round 7. So I'll go ahead and burn away the stress here on Kate. The only problem is that Kate cannot hit the front row with a bleed. I said by Lars.
Them all.
That was not who I wanted to click on. It's good that we're getting all these sort of snafus out of the way early here. Alright. Yeah, again, that's not who I wanted to click on. Let's dial it back here a bit, Brain. We're making some silly plays here. Alright, so we finally landed a bleed on the front champion. Only took 8 rounds to do so. And the champion should die here. There you go, Mal. That's all I wanted you to do. I just wanted you to heal your own stress. I know. How thoughtless of me. Go ahead and top Lars off. Up as much as we can. No, the champion's guaranteed to die next turn no matter what. I'm gonna miss. There we go.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
A lot of gold. Yeah, I guess. And we still don't really need gold, but it's always good to have it. You just never know when you're gonna need it.
Staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
Fortunately, I got rid of our only our final remaining herbs, so I would not be able to get that debuff off of Boston.
We require only the strength to follow it.
Now this is gonna be a group that's much easier for us to deal with because they don't have a ridiculous amount of protection behind them. They also don't have really, really high bleed resist, except for... No, they're all 60. 60, 65. Not bad. Again, going after the Sycophants. take those out as fast as possible. The sooner you can get rid of the sycophants, the happier you'll be, I promise. Alright, so that sycophant's dead. Subterranean skewer for the Chevalier.
Their formation is broken.
I think I hit the wrong one. Yep, maintain, I hit the wrong one. Alright. Alright. Again, as long as we're getting these snafus out of the way early. I just hit by Lars. Doesn't matter if he lands the bleed. He didn't.
The slow death. Unforeseen. Unforgiving.
Go ahead and have Malph chip away at that stress real quick. Then Lars can give him the heal next turn. We go for a stun here. We're not going to be able to stun the supplicant. Because for some odd reason, they have 195 stun resist. But I'm happy to get a stun on the Chevalier. The Chevalier. Here we'll go for a heal on Malph. Nice heal by Lars. And then Malph can go for some bleeds on the Chevalier. Let's try to take him down. I mean, the Chevalier is, like, honestly not that dangerous. As long as you can keep everyone above lethal range in, like, anticipation of him landing his dots, he should be fine. Where they get dangerous is when they start throwing around a bunch of bleeding, a bunch of bleed dots. That's where you're going to get in trouble. I'm actually going to go for the supplicant here, because the Chevrolet is going to be dead soon. There we go. 15 damage on the bleed, I like it. Go ahead for a little bit of a spot heal on everybody.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
There we go. Alright.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
We're not gonna get a secret room. Come on now. What game do you think we're playing, Sinvicta? I think we're playing Darkest Dungeon, Sinvicta. Oh, we kind of are, but... This is what my brain sounds like when it's been sick for a whole week. Alf goes to craving. We might as well give him... Might as well put him on Bloodlust. Nice hit by Malph.
Executed.
At least we got a crit out of that. Alright, so that sycophant's dead no matter what. Fortunately, Malph moving forward sort of screwed our position with Lars, but what can we do? Alright, so we're probably gonna get like three curses here. We're probably going to get, like, two curses here. So we're probably going to get, like, one curse here. So we don't have to worry about getting curses here against the three sycophants. Alpha's just going to hit people. It's fine. We wouldn't expect anything less from a Canadian. Alright. Nice. Good job, Lars. Way to go. All I needed to do was hit him for literally any damage, and it would have been fine. But no! You had to be Mr. Napster over here. You couldn't hit a simple task. Alright. It's alright. Take you down. I'm hoping that Lars gets low enough to where he can just heal Malph. Assuming that Malph, like, doesn't stab anybody again. Should be low enough. Yeah, he's just low enough. So the deafening whine, I didn't realize that there was deafening whine and maddening whine. There's two different attacks. One of them just does pure stress, the other one does an actual stress and stun. I've never noticed that until just now. And yeah, we'll go for some damage. Or not. What was I thinking? Nice Dirk stab there by Malph. One off lethal, count it. Nice. Good job, Gate. Way to go. Go ahead and try to get Lars down a little bit. There we go. Alright.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to scout the last hallway. Never mind. If there's a fight there, which there is, that means that we need to clear the hallway first before we camp. That way we have full effect of all of our stress healing and we get to keep our buffs and all that kind of good stuff. So we finally get a Squiffy Ghast, and I'm not happy about that, but go ahead and buff everybody up. There's no real reason to throw a bleed out right now, because we have to go for the Thrall. Even though there's a Squiffy Ghast, we have to take down the Thrall. That's a rule that is set in stone. You gotta kill the Thrall first. I don't like it. I don't like the fact that the Squiffy Ghast is gonna get even one attack off, but there's not much you can do. Hopefully you can get lucky and get a dodge like that, then we're fine. But now Malph can go ahead and start working on the stress on Lars, while everyone else goes after the Squiffy Ghast. And Malph just stresses everybody out. That's what he does. That's what Michael A.O. Fox does. He just stresses people out. Not going to land a bleed anytime soon, but we can lower his bleed resist down enough to where we can possibly get a bleed on him. You can believe it. If you could believe it!
Festering fear consumes the mind.
I know, Uncle Wayne. Voltas and Austin. It's going to take some stress. And get stunned. Hooray. Lucky us. Could be gas. Almost dead. Malph's going to go ahead and take care of some of the stress here. Kate's got kind of a big job to do right now. Fortunately, she was not able to land it. Well, not for that much damage, anyway. Hoping for just a little bit more. A little bit more damage. Dodge my Malph. Way to go, Malph. Good job. I mean, we might as well move you forward then. You got an achievement called Mine Goes to 11 for some reason. I don't know what that does. I'm gonna go ahead and try to bleed Lars here. And then we can go for big damage. By that I mean completely whiff. Apparently both sides are just whiffing all day today. It's a big old whiff fest. Nice hit by Austin. I think if Judgment crits, it should do a crit heal, no matter what. I'm gonna move Malph back so we can start working on stress. We can actually bleed this ghoul fairly easily. That's what we're gonna do. I could go for a stun, but I'd rather just get the bleeds going. We'll toss a Malph. Twink into this. I'm gonna go ahead and top everybody up right now. Good job.
Precision.
Thank you, Uncle Wayne. So I would delay here if I can just to get just a couple extra stress heals. The Squiffy Ghast obviously did a number on our stress levels. And we can stun him. Well, if we can stun him this turn, that'd be great. Kind of hoping that he wouldn't have done that.
Returns even the boldest gaze.
So I'm going to delay one turn here. We didn't really need to stun, but that's all we can really do with Kate. And Malph needs to cure stress on Austin. And instead he attacked by himself. Alright, well, there you go. One off lethal counted. Good job, Malph.
Size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
But yeah, that's the reason why I hate the Crimson Curse for the 400th time, is because it just acts like any other negative quirk. Takes the control away from you, and I don't like that.
A spark without kindling is a goal without hope.
Alright. I'm not going to use Battle Trance because we don't have a way of removing the debuff. We use Sanctuary. We use, I could use Tiger's Eye. We don't really have to worry about stress, so I'm going to use Tiger's Eye here on Kate. And then Lars can just remove his own stress. And then Malph can take care of Austin's stress during the fight.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
90%. It should be clear up till the boss room.
Wealth beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
Here we go. The Drowned Crew, the final boss in the cove here for season 3. I am happy that we don't have to come back here. Let's do it. Make sure everybody has everything they need. Do we want to get Exsanguinate instead of Redeem? No. Probably not. Probably not. And we'll hold off Dirk's tab. We'll go for Harvest instead. Because Harvest is going to allow us to hit both targets. And Austin is Gucci. Alright. Yep. Here we go.
Even in death, the captain shouts his orders. And the crew obeys.
So I'm not a big fan of this fight. There's a lot of things that have to go right for you to get the win here. I'm going to immediately start helping out Austin. We're going to try to debuff this Joker as much as we can.
Precision and power.
Nice hit there by Kate. Now remember, these things have 50% protection, but if you can get them down low enough and kill them before they get the Heave 2, then you're in prime position. Here comes Heave 2. Gonna stop Lars. Fortunately, we didn't kill him. That's the reason why you want to have a plague doctor in the coves at all times, because they, as you see here, they don't have a lot of blight resist. Unless, of course, they've got Heave 2 going out right now. Way to go, Malph. Good job. Way to hit the already trapped Lars. Appreciate that. Not gonna go for the bleed right now. I'd rather get the buffs out. Get hit there by Lars. Got the bleed. It's nice to have the dodge that work against the heal over time that they get. This channel right here that we have from the Kate, that was not the right target. Thank you.
Devastating blow.
It's nice to have the bleeds that offset the healing that the Drowned Crew gets from Heave 2. Obviously, that's predicated on you landing the bleed. That's where the blight damage really comes into effect, and it's very, very helpful. Not gonna worry about stress right now. We wanna start throwing out damage on the Drowned Crew. Austin tearing it up. And lower that bleed resist enough. We can start getting those bleeds out. Could have gone for the stun there, chose not to. Got greedy for the bleed. Mutiny on Austin. Gets the Heave 2 on Lars. So there's our bleed doing a little bit of counter damage there to that heal, but obviously it's not enough. To win the long game versus the Drowned Crew, you've really got to have the stacking dots. See there, we're not able to do much because his bleed resist is so high during this phase. Another nice crit there by Lars. We may want to have Lars go over for Rapturous, just so he gets a little bit more impact damage. Union Austin. Not that big of a deal. Alright, so we've got him down by about 20%. Swing and a miss. Nice dodge there by Kate. Gonna take this time to get a little bit of the stress taken care of here on Lars. I realize that that's the exact opposite of what I was just talking about, but I would prefer not to have to worry about him causing everyone else to stress out than worrying about him stressing out everybody. I'm not going to go for the bleed right now because his resistance is too high. Good resist by Kate. Another Heave 2 on Lars, and that's fine. Now, back in the good old days when Finale wasn't terrible, You used to be able to completely own this fight with a couple finale jesters. That was the good old days. You just spam Dirk Stab, get in front, and then just go ballistic on the heave twos and the ground crew at the same time. Glorious. Trying to get Lars out of here so he doesn't heal the crew anymore. They've already made back pretty much all the damage we caused last turn. Maybe should have kept Dirk Stab up on Mouth. We're getting slightly unlucky with the bleeds. I know it's Invicta unlucky in Darkest Dungeon. I know. Gonna move Kate forward, and that's fine. Hit my Mouth. If he get the bleed, it's good. Get that bleed debuff down. Bleed resist as much as possible. Gonna go for a cheeky stun here. Try to avoid the heave too. Of course we didn't land it because, I mean, why would we land something? Only has a 95% stun resist versus 165. Alright. Heave 2 on Kate. So it's the long formulaic strategy against this drowned crew boss. You just gotta. It's not a dangerous boss. It can be dangerous if you let them heal too much, and you let the stress get out of control. It can be a dangerous fight. But for the most part, it's just annoying to deal with, especially if you don't have any blight damage. Take with the dead. We should have two pretty good attack opportunities coming up here. Do some major damage.
Vigor is restored.
As you see, they don't do a whole lot of damage. It's just mostly stress. The stress and the debuffs. Lands a deck. It's going to move Mouth forward. Of course, it's not where we want him. So we're going to go ahead and move Mouth back. Waste of an attack, unfortunately. Nice crit there by Lars. Did not get the bleed. We cannot land this flagellant bleed to save our freaking lives, man. I'm gonna go for Iron Swan just because. Try to pour on the damage here. Really wish that we would land a flagellant bleed. Keep 2 on Kate. I'm gonna heal for at least 16 here. I think Mouth should probably refresh everyone's battle ballot. Go ahead and do that. And Kate and Lars will have to go after the drowned anchorman. I hate that I only hit for 5. Thank God Kate crit. I mean, Austin's been doing a pretty good job with the DPS in the back line there. And we're making slow progress. If only Lars could hit those bleeds. If only. Again, I'm asking a lot because they do have 105 base bleed resist. But I'm hopeful. If we can hit him with enough bleeding attacks, then we Gucci fam. Try to go for another stun. We did it. Amazing. It's a freaking miracle.
The wounds of war can be healed.
All right, I'm not gonna go for the heal because I'm trying to capitalize on any damage that we can get right now while heave 2 is not in effect. Now, the problem with the drowned anchorman still being alive right now is that obviously we're gonna have to go 4 rounds with him. Yeah, let's not have Mouth up there. Can't really do much from there. Got him just under 50%. We did it. We landed a flagellant bleed. Amazing. Now we could stun the crew again. However, we're not going to have... I mean, we have a chance of getting the stun. It's not a very good one. I'd rather go for the bleed here. since the resist is 39%, should be guaranteed to land. Mutiny on Lars, whatever. Eve 2, we knew it's coming. But hey, we got the bleed going, so that offsets the healing that they're going to get for two rounds, which is nice. 40 Crush on Austin. Austin doesn't really care. He's completely fine back there. Any damage he takes, he's basically undoing himself. Again, the bleed resist is down. Well, it was down. Forgot that it goes back up. Nice 10 hit there by Lars. 8 stress starting to get a little out of control. Knopf will have to take care of that. So you saw there that the drowned crew were actually at an HP deficit. Oh, Austin, you can't... come on, man. I just got done giving you a rousing, like, ovation here for the job that you've been doing, and all of a sudden you're going to do that? Now I get the move on Lars. By Lars, I mean Lars. Yeah, I mean, go for the stun again. And land it. You got one of the 95s, but not both of them. Alright. Gonna go for a heal here, since doing damage to the Drowned Anchorman's not gonna matter. Keep 2 on Kate. We're choosing to do this the long way. If I wanted to do this the easier way, I would have brought Blight damage. But I was honestly hoping that, like, we would just be able to land a bunch of bleeds and be done with it. So Malv is able to keep Kate under control as far as stress is concerned. Eventually we're going to have to heal with Lars. Like, now would be a pretty good time. But at the same time, I kind of don't want them to keep healing. Because they will heal back to full if you let them. That's where Austin's going to come in, assuming Kate... Hopefully Kate just kills the Anchorman here. Oh. I guess we'll go for a single target heal. I didn't want him to get on death's door. And we didn't kill the Anchorman. Alright. That's 13 damage wasted on the... on the Anchorman instead of the crew, and they healed back about 100% of the HP that we had dealt them in the rare instance that we actually landed a stun.
The wounds of war can be healed, but never hidden.
Please get the debuff at least. Oh, debuff's 140%, by the way. Oh, but God forbid we get it. God forbid we actually pass a resist roll, Darkest Dungeon. Oh no. Can't have that. We can't have Sinvicta passing a resist roll. What are you talking about? Really wish I would have kept Dirkstab. There's a lot of things I wish I would have done for this fight. Trying to do any damage. Hopefully Kate goes after the Anchorman goes. Could go for a stun. Might as well try again. Amazing. Alright. We have a chance to catch... Excuse me. You seem to be mistaken, Darkest Dungeon. I believe that you are stunned. Sir. That's, yeah. Oh, yeah. Now the stun. Okay. That's the clearest case of Darkest Dungeon cheating on camera I think I've ever seen. Wow. So yeah, I guess screw our stun then. That was just an extra attack that you get. this is gonna be a quick run. Gonna be quick run. Thank God Austin hit that judgment. All right, and on turn 19, we're still here. One of these days, Malph is actually going to resist a move, and it's going to be beautiful. But until that day happens, we're going to gonna be here. Stress is starting to get a little bit out of control. I don't know how something so big and inside of a freaking boat can dodge, but hey, what do I know? Woo! Can we land one bleed? Alright, we did it. Amazing. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't record Darkest Dungeon when I'm sick. It's gonna be a quick run. Ain't only doing 10 damage because she just got done using the Barbaric Yacht 2 rounds ago, even though it wears off after 1 round. Alright. We don't need that big damage anyway, Kate. Now Malph is gonna be able to keep up with the stress. I'm not worried about that. And it's not even like we're getting, like, we're playing this badly. It's just that these bleed resists are just ridiculous. That one, I mean, I think it comes down to a matter of we should let Malph get chained and then let Kate and Lars go for broke on the bleeds. But we're still gonna get out DPS though, is the problem. I'll hand them the deck. It's gonna move Austin forward. And I moved him all the way there. Alf doing a good job keeping up with the stress. He's going for any damage that we can right now. Could probably heal. Nice heal by Lars. You know what? Sure. Let's have Austin get heave-tued. That's actually a terrible idea because we don't have any way of dealing damage to. And Austin can only move back one. I would like Kate in the third position, Malph in the first position. The will to fight. And then we just go for a base race against the drowned crew. But again, we have to start landing these bleeds. We can out DPS the bleeds. I believe so, anyway. I'm not proud of this episode. Thank you, Kate. Thank you for doing it in one hit. Thank you. Really hope Austin goes next for Lars. Alright, good. Lars gets to go. We get to go full ham on the crew. Overwatch is starting an update. It's good. By the time we're done with this fight, we might be Overwatch 2 at this point. That's 65 debuff percentage. 65 debuff percentage. The reason why we need the debuff to land is because we need to lower their bleed resist. This whole idea of this fight is predicated around the idea that we're able to bleed them. But not being able to bleed them, man, that gets you the 24-round thingamabobber that you're seeing right now. Got the stun. Apparently stuns don't matter in the game. Not for the drowned crew anyway. We landed a flagellant bleed. What a time to be alive. Amazing. Now, we could also just completely ignore the drowned Anchorman and race with Kate and Lars. I'm willing to try that, because at this point, I'd rather not be here for another 25 rounds. We need to get Malph in the third position, though, so he can start bleeding as well. Well, we can't bleed him yet because we need to get the debuff, so. But once Lars gets that debuff stacked on him, man, oh man, let me tell you what. It's gonna be a glorious day for all mosh pit kind. Crunch a mouth. We're right back to where we were 10 minutes ago. Woo! Nice hit by Kate, finally getting another crit. She needs to be in the first position. Actually, no, she doesn't need to be. We didn't get that. Never mind. Alright, we lowered the bleed resist. Austin needs to get behind Mouth. I don't know if the debuff lasts long enough for us to race with the bleeds, though. That's good that they did Heave 2 as the final attack on this turn. Because if we kill them fast enough, they won't do it on this entire... They won't do it for this entire round. I really wish they hit for more than 5. Oh, Kate, you're killing me. You're just killing me, Kate. Oh, one off lethal, count it. Would this have been any different with Dirk Stab? Maybe, I don't know. We can only get one finale. I mean, Dirk Stab isn't going to do a whole lot. Hey, we got the debuff. Oh my god, Mouth did damage. And we got the bleed. It's the turning point. And again, I realize that I've made this bed, and now I need to sleep in it. Not bringing any blight damage. Trust me, I am aware.
Perched at the
very God forbid we get a bleed resist. You know. If not get the move on Austin, that's great. Good to hear. I like it. Like what I'm seeing. Gonna go for the bleed here. Because the bleed resist is down. Landed the bleed. Incredible. Have to go for the heal with Lars, unfortunately. Say unfortunately, because that's going to give us less time to do damage to the drowned crew. And on round 29, we've got them below triple digits. What a time to be alive.
Ringing ears, blurred vision, the end approaches.
Hey, you know what? I was feeling lucky with Mouth. There you go. So this is what the fight's supposed to look like from the very start. It all revolves around landing the bleeds, which should have been easier with Lars being a flagellant landing the debuff. The problem is the 65% debuff resist, it apparently is the world breaker of all world breakers, because we could not land that, as evidenced by the 30 rounds that we've been here, Darkest Dungeon. We have to heal Kate here. Kate's getting a little bit too low for me. Oh my god, Lars. You gotta stop hitting for 5, dude. Damage is so bad. Have to go for a heal on Kate. As much as I want to kill the drowned anchor man, we can't lose anyone right now. They would have done that. Okay. Kate lands that. Got the dunk. Lars hopefully lands the debuff and the bleed. He did. Incredible. Mouth. Gotta go for big damage. Go for the bleed. resisted the bleed. That's new. Warning crutch. The timing worked out nice because now that's a whole round that they went without summoning the Anchorman. Now I get the bleed. Kate, you're killing me. You're actually killing me, Kate.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
That's 65 debuff. 65. I mean, at this point, like, I'm gonna try to reapply the debuff. We gotta go for broke here. Keep doing Austin. Austin can, luckily he still has illumination, so he can still hit the first position. The problem is Kate can't hit the first position. Nice hit by Lars. But yes, I know that when you're heaped to, you also don't do that much damage. Still, I need him to hit for more than five. Alright, Kate, you need to land this, like, pretty big time. Any day, Kate. Any day, Kate. Any day, alright. Oh yeah, wait, she can't attack in the first position with that. Well, at least she crit. If you're still watching this video by now, why? Shout out to all of you who actually made it this far. This ridiculous fight. He did it. He's free. Amazing. I gotta say, I'm not gonna miss seeing the Cove anymore, that's for sure. This is also, I think, this might be the first time I've ever gone into this fight without having blight damage.
As life ebbs,
and you're seeing why you need to have blight damage for this fight, right here. Themselves. Hands on deck. Did not move Kate. You really need Austin to be, like, back. If Austin dies, Austin dies. I don't want him to die, but we gotta go for a kill here. Picking for eight. They miss Kate.
They are cursed.
We got him.
To float forever.
Good job, Austin.
Deep in the swirling blackness.
Way to stay alive.
Far beyond
probably
the light's reach.
The worst Darkest Dungeon fight I've ever done. And again, I know that I am the cause of that entire situation, but I was really banking on us not having to worry about a 65% debuff resist. But I guess I shouldn't do that because 65 might as well be 165. And even then, who knows by Darkest Dungeon math. Alright, I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that. I wouldn't be surprised if you didn't, though. It's okay if you didn't. I didn't enjoy it. But, yeah. Hopefully Darkest Dungeon StarCraft will return to normal starting next week when I'm over the sickness. After this episode, I might be having a relapse here. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. As always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!